All right, let's move on then to item two, which is discussion for the location for the proposed new jail for Beaufort County.
Thank you, Mayor. Again, I was to add this to the agenda, just to have a discussion item for you all to be able to discuss. If you all have kept up with our local media outlets, Beaufort County Commissioners recently voted to approve the construction of the county jail facilities in the city and county-owned industrial park. And so this is an opportunity for you all to discuss and direct staff any way you may see fit to direct staff.
Just by way of introduction or announcement, we're happy to have Sheriff Jordan and two of his deputies here with us tonight. Welcome. Any thoughts or comments that the council would like to put forth in by way of discussion?
Mayor, I got quoted in the paper yesterday, and I stated, and I think it was reported this way adequately, I don't feel like that this council needs to interfere with the county and their deciding what they want in the way of a jail or how big a jail they want. And I haven't asked to, and I don't want to be involved in that particular type of the discussions if necessary. However, I did feel a little put out when I recognized that we are at least a major, almost half owner of the industrial park, and the decision was made to put the facility in the industrial park with absolutely no discussion with this council in any way. And I think that if there had been some earlier discussion, we could have had a give and take with the county commissioners and suggested whether we thought it was a good idea or if. I have no idea where they're talking about putting it. Are they talking about putting it in the back or putting it in the front? It's just that we're going to put it out there, and we've not been consulted at all. I told Mr. Brooks and Mr. Mulder earlier, it's sort of like if we own a lot together and all of a sudden y'all come in and say, I'm going to build a house on your lot next week or our lot next week and haven't said the first word about it. And I feel like that we're in the same boat here. The county's told us what they're going to do, but they haven't talked to us about it, and we own half of it.
Fair enough. Other thoughts?
I feel the same way as Councilman Mercer. I don't think that this council should get in the business of telling another governing body where to build, how to build their jail. But I would have hoped that the county commission would have consulted us and coming up with the idea of putting the jail in the industrial park. When I think about industrial park, I think about businesses, companies, corporations going to a area such as that. And I do think that this county does need a new jail and for the safety of the officers and the inmates, but I don't think that putting it in the industrial park personally is a good place. And I also look at it from the side point that maybe it's saving money that way to put it out in that industrial park area.
Councilman Pitt?
I do concur with Reverend Moultrie and Mr. Mercer. It is important to replace the jail. The jail has outlived its usefulness in its current state and its current location. It does need to be changed. It does need to be built because the detention officers who work in the jail, they are themselves inmates for 12 hours. So they desire a safe working environment. However, with Mr. Mercer's concurrence, I do believe the city of Washington does need to have, if at the very least, a representative in some talking point with an involvement. Since we are the largest city in the county seat, and we have the largest municipal police department in the county, which will probably, unfortunately, be used.
Mr. Chairman, by the county commissioner decided to put the jail house in the industrial park. I know that we need a jail, we need a better place for our inmates to be kept. But putting it in an industrial park, in my opinion, I look for businesses to be out there, not a jail. And I would certainly hope that if we consider what we're saying tonight and look at it just a little bit more.
So in summary, what I hear the four of you saying is not so much in any way opposed to the new jail or the size or the concept of even having it in a different location other than downtown. It's more of what is proposed to go into our partnership-owned industrial park. Is that fair to say?
I think so.
Okay. All right. Is there anyone, Sheriff, do you have any comments that you'd like to add to the discussion? Maybe we haven't had much in the way of interaction around the jail, so we're not even sure that we're making what I would call informed comments. But I'll invite you, if you'd like, you don't have to, but if you'd like to give us some insight, we welcome you to come to the podium.
I appreciate any input that you can give on that. I said in the early part of the process that there are a multitude of stakeholders in this thing, not just the county. I've said that again and again. But I will say for about the millionth time since I've taken up this quest almost 18 years ago of talking about a new jail, that we need to propose solutions and talk about what we can do instead of what we can't do, because what I'm concerned about and what my captain and my sergeant, who are in charge of running that jail, are concerned about is safety. My captain said it better than anybody recently on a TV interview, that she waits for that phone call to come. I wait for that phone call to come to tell me that one of my detention officers has been badly injured or killed, that one of my inmates has been badly injured or killed, or that someone has escaped and hurt a citizen. As a matter of fact, we had a detention officer assaulted badly. Luckily, he wasn't hurt, but circumstances were very bad Saturday night. And that's mainly because of the physical plant of that jail. Now, personally, my personal opinion, and there's room for all opinions to come to the table, but they need to come, and they need to come now. We don't need to keep delaying this thing. My personal opinion is that it's not feasible from a safety standpoint, from a functional standpoint, and from the standpoint of serving the people of this county to build it on its present location. I have worked every hurricane that's hit this county since 1998. And I can tell you that we are surrounded by a virtual moat when the hurricanes come, and we fight the water intrusion. The downtown merchants can tell you that. Anyone who lives downtown can tell you about the water problems. That also cuts us off from our support facilities, such as the hospital, from fire and rescue. And so we need to look for high ground, but we also need to look for a place that's easy to expand for our future needs. That jail was designed back in the 70s, and I'm sure it was designed by men and women with the best of intentions, but it was almost immediately obsolete. In terms of being an attraction for downtown, I want to remind you that in the early 70s, it brought infamy to downtown Washington in the form of a case called the Joanne Little case, brought national exposure. And we have struggled to keep our head above waters with the help of many good people, and we'll continue to do that. But I submit to you that we need to plan for the best for everyone we serve for the future. And I think that means we're going to have to find a location. It doesn't have to be the industrial park. It doesn't have to be any particular location. And it is not the job of the sheriff to select that location. But I beseech you to work with the county commissioners or anyone else to keep this process rolling along. If that does not happen, then like a lot of jails that get built, we will get built when something bad does happen and there's a lawsuit and a judge is telling us when, where, and how to build that jail. So I'm glad to hear this discussion. I'll come over here anytime that you want to discuss the jail, answer any questions. I'll meet with any of you to discuss it. But I'm asking you, because you are stakeholders in it, to please help with this. And I'll be glad to answer any questions that anybody has about it. But thank you for this opportunity.
Yeah, absolutely. Any questions for the sheriff?
I don't have any questions, but I think we all concur that we need a jail.
Right.
And the sooner the better. That's just a question of their decision as to what they're going to build. And if they're going to build it on property that we partially own, but I think we need some consultation. Other than that, we don't need to get involved.
And I think that that's certainly a valid question, a question that's best settled between the two elected bodies. It's not up to the sheriff to do that. One thing I would, with your indulgence, like to address, because I've seen some people here who've asked me this question from the Downtown Merchants Association, and people with rightful concerns about the relocation of the jail and how that may impact upon them. And I'm not, once again, I'm not a business owner. I'm not really qualified to give an educated opinion on how that may affect them. From my standpoint, though, once again, what I see is a severe lack of safety for the people that work in there, the people that serve time in there, and the people of this county because of the terrible condition of that jail. I wish it were feasible to keep it and keep it functioning in the same location. That would be nice. But we've already had plans laid out to say that not only would it be more expensive to build that structure initially, it would be exponentially more expensive over the years to operate the structure that has to be built. So once again, I'm not an architect or anything like that, but what I would like to ultimately see, and I'm glad to hear that you join me, the majority of you join me in that opinion, I'd like to see a structure that once it's built 50 years from now, it's going to be good for all of us, and we're not going to be in the same situation. And as to the impact on downtown, I would love to hear what people's thoughts are on that. I do have some thoughts of my own, but before I express those, I'd like to hear what some of the other folks have to say. I've started some of those conversations the other night at the Civic Center and didn't get a chance to finish them, so perhaps somebody will enlighten me about what some of their feelings are in terms of the impact on business in the downtown area.
Well, what we probably should do is schedule a public hearing, because I think there is there's a myriad of opinions or concerns around that. I think generally the concern is not so much for the jail itself, but for the courthouse and so forth. We would hate to see that leave downtown. There's been a courthouse near that intersection for over 200 years, and we'd want that to stay. And I know the two don't necessarily have to leave together.
Right. I think we have some precedents that we can examine here locally also. And the plan, as it's been expressed so far, is not to relocate the courthouse. It's to transport inmates and also to do as much video conferencing as we can to accomplish the hearings that can be done that way without the risk and expense of transporting. But there are some precedents that we can examine some other communities. I'll give you an example, Newbern, which moved their jail. And there was quite a bit of controversy surrounding that from certain areas of the community. But downtown Newbern has flourished, and the courthouse remains downtown, although they are talking about putting certain courtrooms out there, operating them at the jail. Greenville is another place where the jail proper moved from downtown, the downtown area, many years ago. So there are other communities that have made it work for them, and you know, I hope that if that's the case, that it will certainly work in the best interest of Washington.
Right, and you know, again, I think it's been expressed by the council, we're very respectful of the county's responsibility and role in that, and then we've tried to take a respectful position on that. The thing that got our attention first and foremost was the industrial park, which is a partner-owned property, and so that's really what brought this discussion to bear. But now that we've started it, and I appreciate your invitation and agreement that stakeholders should be at the table at least to express our opinions, and we'll continue to do that.
Absolutely, and the people that live in any community where the jail is, where we contemplate building a jail, will certainly be interested in it. You know, it's ironic that on the one hand, you've got people that don't want a jail to leave, but on the other hand, when you try to build it somewhere, a lot of people won't want it there.
Yeah.
So, you know, that's. But once again, everybody in the county, every citizen in this county has a stake in this. So we welcome anybody's opinions, and we welcome the opportunity to discuss their opinions.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
Well, thanks for being with us. Thank you. Any other comments location? Okay. Let's take up the third item for discussion.